Okay, ladies and gentlemen, I think we should start, although we are still expecting some more participants. I would like to welcome you very much for this workshop, European Common Agricultural Policy after 2013, Public Goods, the Missing Link. And I would like also to welcome, as the representative of the Rice Foundation, Mr. Corrado Pizio Pirilli, who is, and many of you know, the former chef de cabinet of Franz Fischler, the former agricultural commissioner. And I was very much pleased to take over her their idea and their initiative to have a sort of workshop dealing with those questions on public goods and the link on agricultural policy. I welcome many colleagues from the agricultural, from the budget committee, Rapporteur Georges Lein, who presented a very interesting report, working now on hundreds of amendments, which shows the variety of positions in Europe on agricultural policy as well. I welcome representatives from the other European institutions and also from professional organizations. And I think talking about the future development of European agricultural policy in the context of the discussion of Europe 2020, in the context of the new financial perspective, where Parliament will establish a new temporary committee, it's very important that we talk about those aspects where the European agricultural policy, where are the goals, where are the right instruments, and later talk about the budget. We have to talk and to define the goals and instruments for a sustainable and competitive agriculture in the European and also in a worldwide context. You know, there are many questions linked to this, the question of decoupling, the discussion of flat rate. And we should never forget in this situation that we were facing already within 18 years three big reforms, which were needed, and finally, which were also a success. This is sometimes a bit forgotten outside of the agricultural community, and these reforms always were necessary, but they were also big challenges for the farming community. And so I would like to say also that as far as reforms and further developments is concerned, agricultural policy in Europe starts not with zero or on a negative background. This is very important to say. But what is necessary, of course, in the sort of competition between policy areas and the discussion of the European budget, where member states like to link it to 1% of the GNI because Europe is not capable to spend the money in a proper way. This is sometimes the opinion in the headquarters of member states. We have to discuss about the future challenges and also about the public goods, the agricultural community and rural areas could contribute in a society which is more and more urbanized. And therefore, I welcome very much that we have the opportunity today to first to get three presentations, first from Mr. Patrick ten Brink from the Institute for European Environment Policy on the economics of ecosystems and biodiversity, followed second by a presentation from Professor Alan Buckwell, Policy Director, Country, Land and Business Association, talking about the public goods from private land. And third, Mr. David Baldock, on my right-hand side, talking about the provision of public goods through agriculture in the EU. And then, of course, followed by a discussion with all of you. Thank you very much for your interest, and I just would like to give first the floor to my neighbor, Corrado Pizio Pirilli. Please, you have the floor.